wanted to preface this a little bit. I had first read this story when Bob's health was going, when he was over in the Ukraine, so it hit me kind of hard. I had to go back and read it again, and that bombed me too. The body game took the old Twilight Zone trope of old people going to buy new bodies in the showroom and gave it a very post-Ronald Reagan twist. The poorer you are, the worse shape your new body is in that you get. The narrator's grandfather, a kindly man who worked all his life for the popular myth of the American dream, is subjected to one of the most savage near deaths possible at the hands of his new body and the shyster who sold it to him for his life savings. We are dragged along through this gut-wrenching descent into a kind of social service hell, with the narrator only cordially stating facts in a letter he's writing to his senator and entreating his senator to help his grandfather, until the coda of the story, which is here. And just one other thing I wanted to say about it. When I got this excerpt from Gail, Bob had it marked up. She gave me the whole story, but the only part that was marked up was the part that I wanted to use. And, of course, he died in 2005, but she said, he knew. But yeah, the coda of the story happens here. But that brings me to the second reason I've written you, Senator. I've been talking it over with some of my buddies. This golden age is not so golden for people like us. We can't go on knowing that other people have privileges like long life that we don't have. We figure this stuff has gone on long enough. We're going to declare war. Men ought to be roughly equal, and no laws are going to do that. So our program is to kill rich guys. Do away with them entirely. That may not sound very constructive, as the TV says, but to us it looks simple, straightforward, and we think it'll be effective. We'll kill anyone and everyone who has a lot more than we do. The rich are like us, or we're like them, or until we all meet in the middle. So, Senator, I hope you help my grandfather. If you do, we'll be glad to give you 3 weeks to get rid of your wealth. I expect you'll see it our way. So here's looking at you, Senator, right down the sights of a gun. Wow. Nice.